This is the Heyloo RS5. And sa video na to, pag-uusapan natin lahat ng mga features ng smartwatch na to to help you decide if the RS5 should be your next smartwatch. Before we begin, if you are someone who loves tech news, tutorials, and unboxing videos like this one, please consider subscribing. Kasi nag-upload ako ng mga informative and helpful videos regularly. With that being said, eto yung box ng RS5. And sa harap, may picture ng smartwatch natin to give you an idea what the watch looks like. Sa likod naman, we have a short list of some of its features. Meron siyang 2.01-inch AMOLED display, 150 workout modes, Bluetooth calling to answer mobile phone calls on your watch, health monitoring which includes heart rate, SpO2, and sleep monitoring. And finally, the RS5 can last up to 9 days of battery life for typical usage and 20 days naman for basic usage. So open na natin yung box. Pagka-open, nandyan agad yung watch natin. Then sa ilalim, we have our Pogo pin type charger, our user guide, and an extra woven style nylon strap. The outer side of the strap is smooth and by the looks of it, mukhang maganda rin yung quality ng material na ginamit kaya hindi siya madali maghimulmol. Yung inner part naman is textured because it is a velcro lock. This strap gives you an option for a more casual look. And nagustuhan ko na may included ng ganito kaya hindi ko na kailangan pang bumili. But since medyo pawisin ako, magagamit ko lang to indoors or kapag naka-aircon. Kasi for sure, mag-aabsorb siya ng pawis kasi nga nylon siya. Nevertheless, this is still a big thumbs up kasi sucker talaga ako ng mga freebies. Now, moving on with our watch. Yung default strap naman niya is made of silicone. Maganda yung quality niya and smooth yung feel ng material on both sides. Soft yung material pero I could tell na hindi siya madali mag-crack or ma-deform. Feel ko mas magagamit ko to for everyday use kesa dun sa nylon strap. Dahil bukod sa mas durable yung material niya, sweat resistant din siya and mas madali siyang eterno sa mga damit kasi nga color black lang siya. As mentioned a while ago, we have a 2.01-inch AMOLED display na may 75% screen to body ratio. Medyo chamfered yung edges nung glass face natin. And napansin ko na wala siyang kasamang screen protector, which is kinda disappointing. Anyway, yung body niya is made of metal, which according to Heyloo is aircraft grade quality. So in fairness, pagdating sa materials, hindi rin basta-basta yung mga ginamit nila dito. Our Heyloo RS5 measures only 10.5mm thick and isa rin to sa lightest smartwatch na nagamit ko, weighing only 51 grams. Madalas na overlook tong part na to, pero yung weight ng smartwatch is a big deal. Lalo na if you're planning to wear this to monitor your sleep cycle. Sa likod, makikita nyo tong apat na sensors. And this part right here is made of hard plastic. Sa top part, nandito yung charging pin natin. And eto naman sa upper left, yung microphone. Sa left side, we have a pair of speakers. And sa right side is the crown. That functions as a wake-up button for the watch. And you may also use this for navigation. The Heyloo RS5 has an IP68 waterproof rating. Kaya you can use this while swimming. Our smartwatch has a 300 mAh battery. A significant improvement over the RS4 and RS4 Plus na parehong 230 mAh lang yung capacity. This is advertised to last up to 9 days even with 24-hour heart monitoring. Pero sa experience ko, it only lasted around 5.5 days. Charging speed naman was decent kasi inabot lang ako ng 1 hour and 15 minutes from 0 to 100%. Our watch has a 60Hz refresh rate kaya battery smooth yung experience when you click an icon or when swiping left and right. Speaking of swiping, when we swipe down, we'll see these widgets. Ito naman sets the arrangement of the apps. Pwedeng honeycomb, which is similar with the interface of the Apple Watch, 9-box grid or list. This is the do not disturb button. And you can either turn it on permanently or pwede rin na scheduled lang at a specific time. This is the screen brightness setting. And hindi siya gaya ng mga phones na nag-i-increase or decrease gradually pag dinadrag. Yung kanya is fixed lang into 4 intensity levels. This one is the phone finder. So kung sakaling ma-misplace mo yung phone mo, click mo lang tong icon na to. And as you can see, magre-ring yung phone natin. As long as it's within the range of the Bluetooth connection. And this one is the low power mode in case na low bat na kayo and you want to conserve your battery life. Pag naka-activate yan, yung vibration, wake-up gesture, and notifications will be turned off. Last widget is the settings. Dito, we can select the style of the watch face, toggle the switch of the always-on display, and themes. Sa loob naman ng brightness setting, nandyan yung screen time option. Nung una, nahirapan ako. Kasi yung default niya is 5 seconds lang. Then, mag-auto sleep na yung screen. So, if you want to extend it, pwede kang mamili between 5, 10, or 15 seconds. And lastly, you can click on system to reboot, power off, or reset your device. When you swipe right naman, you'll have a separate window with the time, date, day, weather, and the 4 most recent apps that you've opened. When you swipe left naman, we have our daily step count, sleep record, heart rate, blood oxygen, mood, stress, and weather. You can customize this kung ano lang yung gusto mong include by clicking on this button. Then from there, pwede mong i-add or i-remove lahat ng gusto mong makita sa selection. We don't have a double tap to wake function. The only way to wake this up is by clicking or rotating the crown. Pag clinic mo siya, mapupunta ka sa pinaka-home screen natin, which is a collection of all our health monitoring apps like heart rate, sleep cycle, SpO2 levels, and stress monitoring. If you have a more active lifestyle and you love sports, then you should check out the workout feature. Kasi meron ditong 150 workout modes. Pipiliin mo na lang kung anong magiging workout task mo for the day. We also have a music player, an alarm clock, a calculator, and the voice assistant feature. Finally, let me show you the Halo Fan app. You can sign up for an account using your email address. Then pag okay na, you can go to your profile settings. Dito, you can set your avatar picture, your nickname, gender, age, height, and weight. I think you should set your height and weight as accurately as possible to get more precise results with all our health monitoring apps. You can also set personal targets, like your target number of steps and calories. Each time naman na ma-reach mo yung targets na yan, the watch will set off a congratulatory notification. Pero ang pinaka-excited ako na ipakita sa inyo is our watch face gallery. Kasi sobrang daming options to choose from. If you swipe down, you will see them grouped into different categories. May modern minimalist, classic, artistic, and sports health. Kung natatamad ka naman na i-click yan isa-isa, you can see all of them here. If I'm not mistaken, 150 yung available na watch face na pwede mong pagpilian. The Halo RS5 normally sells for 3,000 pesos, but you can get this at a discounted price of 2,100 pesos. You can also use the codes na ilalagay ko sa description box from June 6 to 10 to get even bigger discounts. You can use the code 1 up to June 10 and yung code 2 naman hanggang June 30. If you are looking for a smartwatch na lightweight, may basic health monitoring apps and workout modes, may app support, IP68 rated, and higit sa lahat, may over 150 watch faces na pwede mong pagpilian, then you should definitely get the Halo RS5. If you have questions and suggestions for our next video, leave a comment down below and I'll make sure to reply. So that's it. See you on the next one.